Good morning to you all. Welcome to the last session of FB Live, 32nd in the lockdown period. Hi Sridhar Babu. Hi Rajesh Khanna. Good morning to you. Welcome. Hi Lakshmi. Welcome. Jay Chandar. Kunala, Hemant Reddy Garu, Prasad, Mamane, Surya Teja, good morning to you all, Ajit Kumar, Mallikarjun, Manlik Garu, Namaste, welcome sir, Sanjay Kumar Chauhan, Arjun Kumar, hi Pradeep Dharam, Karthikeyan Murugesan, Sajid Sheikh, Sriram Kane, hi Valavo, welcome to you sir. I will send you the details maybe today or tomorrow, Valavo sir. Hi DRK, hi Tamil Selvan, welcome. Bangar Vaishnavi. Hi Arjun Kumar. Request you all to stay till end today because this is a topic that you have to, KGK Garu, welcome, Namaste. Good morning to you. Today's topic, unless you hear from beginning till end, it is not complete. Hi DP. Durga Prasad, Kakinada. Oh, okay, okay. Thank you, Durga Prasad, Sunita, Prashant Sharma, Venkata Krishna, Chaitanya, Saju Abhi, Sivaraman from Riyadh, welcome. Sorry for the last day. Good morning to you all, Jay Chandar. Yeah, it's like last exam for me. And our exams used to happen in summer and it also happening in summer. Satyapal, welcome. Mohammad Ishaq, Ananda Bey. Welcome to you all. Vamsi, Anna Pragada. Aryan, Gajavelli. Aryan is a man who has written excellent write-up report on first series one, Aryan. Very good. You will receive the prize money. Maul Rao, hi Chitti Babu. Hi Madhavi. Ladani. Hi Abdul Kalam. Mohammad Ishaq. Yeah, I'm a bit excited for being able to achieve this milestone of 32 lectures with all of you encouraging me. Venkat Rao, Yash Kinvasra, hi Gaurinath, and Shadab Alam, hi Purnachandar, good morning to you all. Kiran Kadam, Ravindra Kole, Srinivas Deshmukh, Kati Varapu, Ravi Kumar, Anudeep, good morning to you all, Sandeep Shankar, hope you are getting video and audio proper. Lifetime achievement, yeah, it's a big thing I did. Of course earlier I did one leap of 70 hours, 56, of course that is. Hi DP, welcome. Durga Prasad was my IIT classmate, and he is working for Panchayat Raj in Andhra Pradesh as executive engineer. Hari Prasad, welcome. Yogesh, Ashok Sharma ji, Maul Rao garu, Kumaresan, Loganathan. Hi Dansilan garu, welcome. Ajit Kumar, so many new friends I made during this session. Kameshra garu from Indore, Dansilan garu from Chennai, of course KGK garu I know, lot of people. It helped me a lot. Rao Kosari garu, Narendra Madhav, good morning. We'll be starting in another 1 minute. Namaste Lakshmi Narasimha. Nelly Shetty Bharat, good morning. Arbaz Parvez. Kattivarapu Ravikumar, Nitesh Dwivedi. So welcome you all. We'll start the session now. It is time. Yeah, ethics and professional issues in civil engineering. So this is a great topic, and I feel all civil engineers should be conscious about this subject. Yeah, Tamil Selvan is my first colleague. Convert into textbook for PG and BTech students. Yes, sir. So we'll start now. Thank you all for your encouragement. So when we talk about engineers and ethics, we should definitely remember Sir Mokshagundam Visvesaraya, who lived a long cherished life of 101 years. And he is the only engineer in India coveted with the Bharat Ratna. And he is an engineer who has gone beyond the boundaries of engineering. He solved problems wherever in those days, 100 years back, like Bihar or Hyderabad floods or Mysore state. He thought about the economics of upliftment of the people actually. He's an engineer we all should emulate. And there is a small story, I don't know if you have read in WhatsApp. I also read in WhatsApp and I shared in Facebook also. It seems when he was doing the survey in one of the villages, he was carrying two candles, one belonging to the government, one his personal. So once till he did the work, he was using official candle in the evening. Those days power was not there. And once he finished his work, he put off that candle and lit up the candle of his personal use. So that is the level of honesty he had, if we all should emulate that. Next, regarding ethics, nowadays I see the younger generation saying that they call them nerds, those who are good academically and attending all the classes, students particularly. But unfortunately, I am missing many students because of their online classes. Yeah, Visvesaraya, you should attend September 15th Engineers Day. Or I'll share the videos in Facebook page of Visvesaraya's life. A great man, a great engineer to emulate actually. So Mahatma Gandhi said, he's another great man in our country who has brought us independent, who worked for bringing independence. And also he said many good things. He taught many good things to Indians actually, and world of course. So when you are good, when you follow the ethical values, the people will ignore you. They think you are a written off case like that. And even they laugh at you. In the schools it happens, in the business it happens. If you say that you are not working for money, you are working for ethics, people will laugh at you. Then they fight with you. And if they fight with you, then you will win. So it is Mahatma Gandhi's saying. So we should all follow this. Namaste Krishnamurti Garu. He is my Guru Garu. Krishnamurti Garu is online. I am very happy. he's attending my lecture. He mentored me. If I am a consultant, I learned a lot of things from Krishnamurti Gar. He is the man who asked me to become an engineer consultant. He who found consulting engineer in me immediately after BTech. He counseled me. That's why I do this to all the people. I learned from him that we should help engineers to be on their own. So thank you, sir. Namaste. So recent history has taught us that ethics and character count people actually. We have seen the organizations like Enron, Arthur Andersen, Lehman Brothers, Health South, they are all destroyed. And many other companies seriously damaged because like AIG, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and we have seen in India also many companies, I don't name them. I don't have to. You all know Indian companies, how they collapsed just because of lack of governance, lack of corporate governance, I would say. So executives with massive ambition and intelligence without moral compass in today's ultra-competitive, high-tech, independent business world. We see lot of people, and I see many civil engineers comparing themselves with this kind of executives. I mean, it's not a life. We cannot compare with people who are intelligent, who are earning more money, but they don't have moral compass. So that is very important. So we should all take the example of this. So in our profession in engineering, we start our careers as assistant executive engineer or graduate engineer trainee or assistant design engineer or a supervising engineer, or do internship, or in academics, teaching assistants in academics we start, and research associates in research. So these are all the career opportunities for any civil engineer. Nowadays, I'm seeing when I go to engineering colleges, I ask the students, is any one of you willing to become academician? None of them raise up their hands. And recently in Kakinada Engineering College, one student raised the hand, and she is a topper, and she attended classes more than 90%. And we need such people. And all the civil engineers, I have seen another engineer in my office like about 15-20 years back. He was earning 25,000 rupees per month in my office with the 2-3 years experience. He's good actually. And then one day he came and told me, sir, I got a job in government. I want to go and join that job, assistant executive engineer. I asked him, what will be the salary you get? He said 12,000 rupees. Then I was surprised. I said, I have seen my engineers going for double the salary. Why you are going for half the salary? His reaction was, sir, I get other money also in the government. This is the attitude that is killing our profession, that is killing our respect as engineers in the society. So we engineers should think of earning money in a rightful manner. We should not go for other options, actually. We are very intelligent. The fact that we have become engineers itself shows that we have something with us. If we have completed the degree and if we start learning, we are all analytical people, and I am sure none of us have to worry about our career or earning if we do our job properly. And let us be happy with what we can earn being proper. This is the ethics in career, I would like to say, because recently, last year, I had the opportunity to interact with a battery of engineers in a state reviewing some projects in irrigation, in urban development. I felt very sad for engineers who have become like they just implement the instructions of the politicians or government. And it's a very sad state of affair. And even today in Telangana, Hyderabad, it is happening. One shed has collapsed in the newspaper. In our consulting engineers, the discussion is going on. in the newspapers, the marketing department officials say that the shed, normally in the month of April, May, there will be wind speed of 40 kilometers per hour. And now it is double. That's why shed has collapsed. Is it engineering? Why a non-engineer should talk about safety of the structure? And similarly, a commissioner, municipal Hyderabad GHMC commissioner once, when the roads were in bad condition, he made a statement in the paper that the normally roads are designed for 2 centimeters of the rain. And this year, there are rains of 4 centimeters. That's why roads are damaged. Is it engineering? Why a commissioner should talk about structures? Why don't civil engineers protest such statements and make them realize how the roads are designed and what is the life of a road 20 years? So this is the ethics. We engineers, if we follow ethics and if we are strict, we should go and put our foot down to the officers who make such wrong statements and give a wrong impression to the public that as if engineers can't design these public utilities like roads or market yard shed. And in Hindu newspaper today, it seems they have written it is a temporary shed. Even for temporary structures, there is a caudal provision. The life of temporary structure written, wind written period is 25 years. So we have to design for such wind speed, and it has collapsed today. So this is the problem. Engineers should exist. We are all engineers. Let us show our presence to people. That's what I'm going to talk today. So we have ethics, builders, contractors, and developers. One developer made a statement in one of the engineers' meet. He came and said, the engineers don't do proper service. I asked him, how many engineers are you employing? How many consultants you have in your projects? I said, if engineers are not engaged in the projects, how engineers get nurtured? Engineering gets nurtured. No political pressure. We should put our foot down. If we are afraid, if we are weak only, we will succumb to political pressures. We should follow our norms. Okay, let them throw. We have seen IAS officers IAS officers being transferred. We have seen Kemke in Haryana cadre. He was transferred 54 times. What happens to him? If we are good, let us take that and be good for life. I have seen one superintendent engineer, Abraham, I don't mind mentioning his name, retired R&B engineer who is retired as a superintendent engineer. He told me once proudly that when he was a deputy executive engineer, for a promotion, he was asked to pay a lakh of rupees in the secretariat and he refused to pay and he didn't get the promotion. If he had got the promotion at that time, he would have retired as a chief engineer. Now he has retired as a SE and he is working still, as I know, till 75 years. After retirement also, he is a very good designer. So what he lost retiring as a SE? So let us commit ourselves to being ethical. So that's what is the topic of today. And we have computer-aided design engineers, we have quantity survey, we have planning, scheduling, we have construction engineers, and we can take this as a beautiful career. What I want to tell you today is, being a civil engineer, you can be the happiest man, being ethical also. This is the topic today. So, engineering needs investigation, all the steps. Why I'm showing this is I'm just refreshing my thought of engineering work. So every engineer should focus on proper topographic survey, proper geotechnical investigation, environmental investigation. We have seen what happened in Cochin without following the norms. What happened? Building collapsed. Building was dismantled. It is like our own baby being killed before us. We are engineers. We want to see our structures live for their life. And water, waste disposal, all this we have to investigate for any project that we are involved in. Yeah. Oh, sorry. Sorry. When I am trying to touch. Yeah. Technology now. Engineering also, we should start implementing the technology. We are seeing now how we are utilizing the online classes and all that. Similarly, we have building information modeling. We have virtual modeling. We have virtual reality. We have augmented reality. These are all the new technologies. We should also be abreast, because in future we can we need not go to the site. Sitting in my office, I can visit the site. That is augmented reality. This technology will improve, and we all should move towards that. And project cost, quality, timely execution, and delivery assurance. I mean, I am seeing some people giving some examples of seniors not allowing and all. Please, let us be firm. Let us not find reasons for not being firm, not following ethical values. No reason for that. The only one, you can have 100 reasons for not being ethical, but one reason for being ethical is your personality, your consciousness, your conscience. These are the only things that will make you ethical. You can be ethical. There is no escape route for that. Let us be that. Today, let us accept, let us go through all this. And the end of the session, I'll definitely take your questions. I'll spend more time for questions today after 1 hour also. So project vision, location reconnaissance, and the project feasibility and phasing, and product identification, implementation strategy, project management, finance, all these subjects we can rule actually. So for that, I'm going to explain our professional issues and all today. And master planning, concept design, value engineering workshops for every project. Let us think of these things. Statutory appraisal, design development, DPR, technical specifications, and procurement process, vendor registration. Let us insist on every client, whether it is government or private, to go through the proper process of vendor registration, pre-qualification, and bidding process. And we have very good procurement methods like design build, lump sum contracts, EPC contracts, labor material, plant and machine, LMP contracts, that is cost plus models. And we must have a quality plan, assurance, quality control, quality audit. This should be the process. If somebody is verifying your records, it is not that he is finding fault with you. He is trying to help you implement proper quality plan. So audit is always a good thing. Once my client asked me, shall I get a peer reviewer for our design? I said, I'm the happiest man if some other engineer verifies my design. Because I may do mistake. So let us not have ego for accepting such audits. And construction engineering, this also we shared in geotechnical aspects like shoring and all that, and structural execution, and finishes execution, and construction management, construction supervision, construction coordination, quantity survey, quantity survey billing, in billing and all that, and cost of the project ultimately. So we also have to take care of the change management. We must focus on these things. Safety, planning of safety, statutory compliances, surveillance of the project, and contract administration and management, snag list and desnagging, as built manuals to be prepared, handed over to the society or the end user. And defect liability period and obligatory maintenance and even arbitrations, end of the project. So our focus, let us be very clear of this project cycle, start to end, from concept to commissioning of the projects, every engineer. Let us question ourselves every day, how much of engineering we have done out of 24 hours today. This is the question every engineer has to focus. And if I am sure, if we spend more time on engineering, and if we do engineering, then we will definitely make a better built environment in our country. So now, ethics and career. So what are all the things? Attire, I always say that we must present ourselves pleasantly to the clients. This is trained by my boss to me. Once I was sitting with bathroom slippers and a worn out jean and a t-shirt, sagged and faded and without shaving. I was sitting in my office in my first job. So my boss looked at me and said, what is this? I said, what is wrong? He said, no, everything is wrong. You have to wear shoes, polished, pointed shoe, a leather shoe. And then you must wear dark color pants. You must wear a light color shirt. And then you must have an oiled hair combed and a haircut and shaved. This is the thing. And believe me, from that day onwards until today, every day I follow the same attire. And so this is the very important thing. Next is the attitude. So we'll talk about attitude more in detail as we move forward. Honesty, integrity, punctuality. This is the biggest problem in our country. And we are laughed at saying IST. So that's why I tried maintaining this 32 days. 11 means 11. And 10:55 means 10:55. I'll connect. So it is possible. And so punctuality is very, very important thing for all of us. And truthfulness, being truthful to your clients. We will face problems if we are not truthful. Truthful, I am not saying any other thing in our technical aspects only. We have to tell the clients what is possible, what is not possible. Let us not, for the sake of appeasing or getting appreciation from the client, say something that is not possible. So we have to be truthful to our clients. And moreover, we should be truthful to the end user, project beneficiary at the end. That means whoever is going to live in a building which we are designing or constructing, we should be truthful to them. That we have followed all the standards, we have followed all the construction practices, and whatever facility is done is designed for their use, for their requirement, like comfort, convenience, and functional aspects, covering all the functional aspects, and a healthy atmosphere. This is the thing which we have to think of. If we do that, whether we are designing a road, whether we are designing a railway station, or whether we are designing a building, anything, office, anything, we should be truthful to the end user. Then you will be a good engineer. You be sensitive to their needs and design proper constructed facilities. So now, I always use this slide. It's my favorite slide for every time. So prevention is better than cure. If you are seeing bad constructions, let us understand that we have to train our engineers. If there are engineers working, and motivate engineers to be engineers. This is another important thing. That means many engineers we see, they do billing, they think of anything other than engineering. Let us motivate the engineers to be engineers. That's what I'm trying to do through my this trust. And enlighten developers and builders to engage engineers. You know, my approximate calculation is every 1 crore spent on construction, it will require one engineer year. That means if our country is spending 20 lakh crores on construction, we should have 20 lakh jobs for the engineers. But we have only 15 lakh engineers, civil engineers in our country, and we see unemployment still for the engineers. That means engineers are not being engaged. So we have to enlighten these people to engage engineers. And next, we should also conduct a campaign that nurtured engineering gets better engineers. That means if people, now they may say, no, engineers are not doing proper job. So we should tell them if engineers are utilized in the projects only, they will learn engineering and they will do better engineering. And they will become better engineers and they will get better engineers. And buildings get distressed without building engineers. So we have building engineers and we have to build engineers. So we have to do that. Otherwise buildings will be bad. Whatever leakages we are seeing, whatever bad concrete we are seeing is because of without engineering, without being engineers, they are doing the projects. So no causes or remedies for projects with good engineers. This is what we should say. If you engage good engineers and those engineers do engineering, then there won't be any problems for the projects. Every project will be good. There is no remedy. That's what I tried explaining all through in 31 lectures. So now ethics and professional issues we are talking about. Charisma without conscience, cleverness without character. a recipe for economic and personal failure of epic proportions. We have seen that. We have seen examples in our country, own country, even in Hyderabad. We have seen so many corporates collapsing. We have seen so many people collapsing because of, we have seen people running away from the country because they don't have conscience. They don't have a character. That's why they had to run away from the country. So President Theodore Roosevelt said, to educate the mind without the morals is to educate a menace to the society. These are all the very important things. So competitiveness, ambition, and innovation, important to success, but be regulated by core ethical principles. This is the most important statement, actually. If you are successful without ethics, that's not a success at all. You have failed internally. So ethical values, core ethical values are internal, actually. You may win externally, but you will not win internally. You will never have a peaceful sleep if you are not following ethical principles. Even if you are not successful, you should be happy because you have not done anything wrong. If you have done anything wrong, you will always be afraid that somebody will come and catch you for the wrongs you are doing. So, basic definition of ethical principles are universal standards of right and wrong. So, we all know what is right, what is wrong. And prescribing the kind of behavior an ethical company or person should and should not engage in. This is the basic definition of ethics. So, we have to do the right things and to build an ethical company or to be an ethical person. These principles provide a guide to making decisions, but they also establish the criteria by which our decision will be judged by others. This is the most important thing. It's not what we do for ourselves. We should also think what others think of when we do something. So the business, in business, how people judge character is critical to sustainable success because it is the basis of trust and credibility. How we do our business is the basis. And both of these essential assets can be destroyed by actions which are perceived to be unethical. So if we think that we are doing unethical but we are successful, it will be destroyed someday, one day. And successful executives must be concerned with both character and reputation. This is the most important point. So Abraham Lincoln described character as the tree and reputation as the shadow. If we think that our character is bad, but it's okay, we are happy, but your shadow will be there. That means people will be observing you. There is no tree without shadow. Similarly, there is no character without reputation. It can be good or it can be bad. So character is what you really are. That is what you really are inside. Yeah, that's right, sir. Somebody else should always say you are good. Reputation is what people think of you. This is the most important thing. Reputation is a function of perceptions. The intentions and actions are honorable and ethical. That is, intention also should be good. And your action also should be good. That is truthfulness. While character is determined and defined by actions, that is honorable and ethical action. So according to 12 ethical principles. So I'll tell you one very good thing now. So these are the 12 ethical values which we think are good, like honesty, very important, integrity, promise keeping, loyalty, fairness, caring, respect for others, law abiding, commitment to excel, leadership, reputation and morale, and accountability. So these are all the 12 ethical values. And one wise man said, write all these 12 good qualities, or there are so many other good qualities, adjectives. You write what all you know. And the wise man said, if you think you have two of these things, you are a very good person. Don't worry about other 10 out of these 12. But try to strengthen those two good qualities that you have. That's what Mahatma Gandhi did. He had two good qualities, truth and non-violence. So he implemented those two, and for that he ignored so many other bad qualities you would have had. So it's not possible to have 100% perfect person. But we have to implement what good we have, we think we can implement sincerely. That's enough actually to be a good person. Don't worry about those qualities which you don't possess. This is what the wise man said. So now, honesty is the best policy. We have a saying actually, honesty is the best policy. Be honest in all communications and actions. Don't worry about the repercussion. If you are honest and if your boss or your client talks something rough to you, don't worry about that, but be honest. After that, they will realize what you did is right or it's not your mistake. Honesty is the cornerstone of the trust, and be truthful, always candid and forthright. This is perfect in honesty. And do not deliberately mislead or deceive others by misrepresentations, overstatements, partial truths. Aswadhama hata kunjaraha. This is a partial truth actually. Kunjaraha is say silently. So selective omission or any other means. So this is the honesty. We have to be correct. And when trust requires it, they supply relevant information and correct misapprehensions of fact. Next is the integrity. Maintain personal integrity. So earn the trust of others through personal integrity. Integrity refers to a wholeness of character demonstrated by the consistency between thoughts, words, and actions. So integrity means what we think and what we say and what we do should all be the same. So we cannot think something and say something and do something else. So this is the most important, and engineers particularly, I always say integrity for engineers means engineers doing being engineers. Engineers should be engineers and do engineering. This is the integrity of engineer actually. Let us not do something else other than engineering in our profession or in our career. Maintaining integrity often requires moral courage, the inner strength to do the right thing. This is what people are asking me. If my boss asks or if politicians put pressure, don't care them actually. You are an engineer, be a perfect engineer. And maintaining integrity often requires moral courage, the inner strength to do the right thing, even when it may cost more than they want to pay. This is the very, very, very important point, sir. And live by ethical principles despite great pressure to do otherwise. And be principled, honorable, upright, and scrupulous. Be scrupulous. And fight for beliefs and do not sacrifice principle for expediency. This is the most important thing. We should not sacrifice the process or principle for the sake of delivering something. There is no point in delivering a half-born baby. You have to do proper, take more time, but don't sacrifice the quality. Take more time, but follow the principles, follow the standards. This is what integrity means actually. So promise keeping, I will not, now RERA has come because this is to make people do promise keeping. So this is the most important thing. And do not interpret agreements in an unreasonably technical or this is what I see many consultants. I mean, contractor is not somebody outside, you know. We have to treat the contractor as the team of the project. And let us realize if the contractor making reasonable profit is not a crime, actually. This is his career and he has to earn for his living, but not unethically. This is very important. So we should take contractor also as part of the thing, and whatever we promise in the project contract, we should not interpret the conditions of contract favorable to the client only. And at the same time, I had an experience. One contractor put a claim of 1 crore rupees in one project, whereas we have recommended 20 lakh rupees as per the contract. Then client called me and asked me to recommend 1 crore. I said, sorry, sir, as per the contract, as an engineer, I can recommend only 20 lakhs. If you want to pay beyond my recommendation, you are the client. It's a private project, of course. You can pay, in appreciation of the work done by the contractor. No, no, contractor has lost. That's not my business. Contractor, we will recommend as per the contract only. If you want to pay to the contractor, amend the contract, I will recommend as per that amended contract. So these are the promise keeping things. We have promise is contract. So we have to, it is our job to implement the contract in letter and spirit. Loyalty. Oh, this is a big thing in companies. Place high value on protecting and advancing the lawful and legitimate interests of the companies and colleagues. And demonstrate loyalty by safeguarding the ability to make independent professional judgments. So how do you get the loyalty from the people who are working for you? So you will get loyalty when you protect their interest, when you give them the due respect, that is very important, dignity to the employees. So the employee should look for these things, not the money alone. Money you can get anyway. If company does well because of you, you will anyway make money out of it, or company will realize. And I always tell my associates, if you are not, if you think you are not paid due salary, that means you are creating asset for the company, in the company, yes, your asset in the company. That's what nowadays we are seeing, this stock options, employee stock options. So this is the thing. Loyalty is the best thing you can show to your company. And fairness, strive to be fair and just in all dealings. Do not exercise power arbitrarily, nor using overreaching or indecent means to gain or maintain any advantage, nor take undue advantage. This is possible in civil engineering, actually. Take advantage of ambiguity in the clauses, ambiguity in the contract. So let's not take that undue advantage. Be fair and manifest a commitment to justice, the equal treatment of individuals, tolerance for the and acceptance of the diversity. Caring, demonstrate compassion and genuine concern for the well-being of others. Be caring, like now we are seeing in construction sites, migrant labor, it's becoming a big issue. And as engineers, we should also think of their well-being. Understand the concept of stakeholders, those who have a stake in the decision because they are affected by it. Always consider the business, financial and emotional consequences of the actions on all stakeholders. Yeah, money is a byproduct, that's right. Demonstrate respect for the human dignity. This is very important. We should all respect others. Let us not degrade any engineer, and let us all respect each other, whether he's a senior engineer or a junior engineer, all are engineers. So let us maintain our dignity, and let's not accept somebody degrading an engineer because he is our opponent. If some other person says he's a bad engineer, if you think you are a good, he's a good engineer, we should demonstrate that. So we should respect every other engineer. Law abiding. This is the abide by laws, rules and regulations. This is one thing I heard. Being Indians, we have been for centuries made to disobey law, actually, because we are invaded by rule outsiders. And we have been protesting the outsiders. So it is possible in our genes. We don't want to follow law. We don't want to follow a rule. So we have to practice very strictly. In fact, CVC, N. Vittal, I don't know how many of you know, he wrote a book after retirement as a Central Vigilance Commission, law abiding or not law abiding. So you have to question yourself when you go and buy medicines in a medical shop. Have you ever insisted for a bill? If you complain about corruption, you must question this. If you are not taking the bill, similarly, petrol bunk, when you go and fill a bike or car, how many times you insisted on a bill with your car number or vehicle number and amount paid, if you are paying by cash particularly? And similarly, how many times you followed the traffic signal, even when there are no vehicles? Have you jumped red signal? So this I am practicing now actually. It's very tough actually. So when you see a red signal, you should stop. That means you are law abiding. And similarly, cell phone driving while talking on phone. These are all the things which you have to self-regulate. So fulfill all the statutory obligations in the projects and be considerate to safety if needed above law. So this is the most important thing. Save environment and resources. This is our responsibility being engineers. Commitment to excellence. This is another important thing. Every engineer pursue excellence all the time in all the things and pursue excellence in performing duties. Be well informed and prepared and constantly endeavor to increase proficiency in all areas of responsibility. We have to keep learning being engineers. When we get the job, we don't have time to learn. So when we don't have work, we should keep learning. And another good saying is excellence is exempted for reasonable delivery to a larger section of society. This is the saying of Google founder Larry Page actually. So you don't have to be 100% excellent and if you are not delivering it in time. So you have to have a reasonable delivery to a larger section of the society. Then excellence can be relaxed a bit. We have seen in water quality, there are relaxations. Similarly, in excellence, there can be a relaxation. Leadership. I have another book written by a consultant in California, engineer, civil engineer. He says that civil engineers lack leadership. We are more bothered about all technology and our passion towards technology. And we ignore our own leadership and management. So exemplify honor and ethics, be conscious of the responsibilities and opportunities of position of leadership. Seek to be positive ethical role models by conduct and brief his requirement. And again, during construction stage, he changes the requirement like elevation. Yeah, he can always do. And seek to be positive, ethical decision making are highly prized. So this is very, very important. We have to be conscious. Reputation and moral, build and protect the company's good reputation and the morale of its employees. Understand the importance of company's reputation as well as the importance of the pride and good morale of employees. Avoid words or actions that might undermine respect and take affirmative steps to correct or prevent inappropriate conduct of others. We are seeing, though Google is such a big company, Google has entered into a lot of litigations and problems because of some of this kind of things. Words or actions that have undermined respect. Accountability, final. We are all accountable to safety of the people who are living. Engineers can destroy or make good living. So acknowledge and accept personal accountability. It is personal accountability. Don't think that you're accountable to some client or some officer. You're accountable to your own self for ethical quality of the decisions and omissions of colleagues, companies, and communities. So this is the most important thing. So now I am coming to the professional issues. Okay, we will be ethical, that's all fine. But are we recognized in our constitution? Engineers are not recognized or not defined in the Indian constitution so far. That is the saddest part of our country's acts actually. So of course now it is in a draft stage. We all engineers have to work for realizing the Engineers Act. So that we should be united for that. So industry, we have this FICCI, CII, public sector companies and all that, and undertaking. NASSCOM we have for IT industry. Academics and research, we have AICTE. We have skill development and finishing school that is required. And technology indigenization. Construction, we have infrastructure, real estate, hospitality. And design and engineering, we have planning, architecture, civil and structure, MEP, project management and project rating. These are all the things we should work for. Now, what is our daily routine? This is my suggestion always to at least students, I'll tell, but I feel every engineer should read at least two newspapers because we have to deal with public requirement. So one vernacular local daily and one English newspaper. And daily minimum 1 hour fitness for civil engineers is important. Because we have to work on sites. So we should have fitness, we should have the stamina. I am, as an engineer, many times have to climb 80 meters tower by the ladder, and I had to climb 14 floors up and down, and another building of 14 floors like that. So be attentive and learn new thing in engineering. So in engineering, it is possible to learn as we drive, as we travel, as we stay in the hotel, as we are on holiday, we can always keep learning. Continuing professional development. This is also important for engineers, because we are professionals, we have to learn, keep learning, and visit or observe construction going around so that you can understand what is happening and good things you can learn. Think of societal problems around you, and teamwork and management and leadership. These are all the things we have to practice. And the professional issues we have is employment and employability, professional societies, engineers associations in our country are more than 1,000. There is no one single engineers association representing civil engineers in our country. This is a big challenge we have before us, and the safety in built environment is a challenge, and sustainability of resources. We use a lot of natural resources like cement, aggregates and all that. And the accountability of engineers. This is, we have to be accountable for what we do. Public infrastructure maintenance and standards. This is what is actually spoiling the reputation of engineers. So every engineer in the department should put their foot down for the right things. Disciplinary issues. We have architect engineer issues. One-upmanship, who is above, is always the issue. Civil engineer and structural engineer, that is construction engineer on site and structural engineer designing the building, and structural engineer and geotechnical engineer, and civil engineer and plumbing sanitary, civil engineer and electrical engineers, so civil engineer and air conditioning. So these are all the interdisciplinary. We have to be conscious and we have to respect each other. We should feel all are required. We cannot decide whether eye is important, ear is important, hands are important, or mouth is important, or nose is important. Everything is important. We are the like a human body for the project. All are required. Let us respect the existence of each other's role. And some projects require structural engineer greater role. Some projects require architect greater role, like that. So let us respect each other. And geotechnical, yeah, Institution of Engineers has got only 80,000 members, out of which 70,000 are inactive. This is a problem. So we have to still work on bringing together all the engineers in our country. So we have 30 million engineers in our country. 30 million, can you imagine? 3 crores, all branches. And we are adding 1.6 million new engineers every year, and 2 lakh civil engineers every year, and create opportunities by mandatory professional compliance. This is the how we get the opportunity. I explained, if every 1 crore spent, if you have one engineer, for one engineer year to be spent, India is spending 20 lakh crores, and for 20 lakh crores, you can create 20 lakh jobs. We have only 15 lakh civil engineers. So we can create opportunities if we have a mandatory professional compliance. Yeah, save resources and energy and reduce wastage by making engineers accountable. So we can take the accountability on our head and create opportunities for us. And spend on technology upgradation. So we have so many schemes like Make in India, Swachh Bharat, Skill India, Startup India, Smart Cities, Housing for All. All things require engineers, and we can position ourselves in each of these things and become entrepreneurs also. And we have to have professional engineers bill in our country. This IC is Indian Council of Engineers. Like you have a Council of Architects, you have a Chartered Accountants, we have the Bar Council of India, we have Medical Council of India. We should have Indian Council of Engineers, who should regulate our engineering profession. And continuing professional development should be made mandatory for engineers, 50 hours every year. Compulsory, you should participate in learning and adding knowledge. and conserve material resources and energy by using effective human resource. So that is, engineers should do this and spend on disaster prevention and reduction. Yeah, I added in the last minute that engineer's role. Sorry, I'll share again. Rangam Satam. Encourage innovation for Indian needs, affordable housing, healthcare, urban infrastructure, traffic management. Traffic management is unfortunately done by traffic police, not engineers. This is the problem actually. So we should insist. Many times it happened, I tried talking to traffic police saying that we will give you better traffic management solutions. And at the moment they say, yes, we will come and we'll meet and discuss, and later they'll forget, they'll go into daily routine. And people are suffering. So we should do this. Flood management is another thing engineers can play a very good role. And then manufacturing is another thing. So these are all the pictures of some of the great projects done in India. So we can see the underground tunnel. We can see the bus station in Vadodara. This is bus station in Vadodara, this left side. And this is a Delhi underground metro, airports, power plants, highways. And we have this Bandra-Varli ceiling bridge, metro station, metro rail, housing in large scale, wind power, irrigation. So many projects happening, so many engineers contributing it. So are we recognized for this? So we should work for doing the best projects to get recognition in the society. We have to publicize our role. So finally, what are the challenges that we have as civil engineers now? Oh yeah, that's, I always forget this zooming. Yeah, that's a good idea, Mohammed. So unity among engineers is a big challenge I see. Engineers don't go together. So I am working for it. And we have to bring together all the engineers in our country into one platform. And we should work for it. Yeah, I am trying to work on it. I am trying to work for this unity. I am ready to do any work for this bringing unity. Integrity is a big challenge in engineering. Quality is okay, we can get trained and implement. Leadership is lacking in our engineers. Economy, economical designs and resources, and managerial abilities is a challenge. Professional ethics is a challenge. That's why I do this topic. And IQ levels is not a challenge. Nowadays, technology is helping us live with the IQ level. Systems and process. Yes, we have to implement systems and process and healthy competition among engineers. And finally, public trust. We have to enhance public trust among people about engineers. They should think engineers can solve their problems. Yeah, quality and innovations, that's right. So we have to create public trust. We have to publicize what good things we are doing. Now social media is so powerful, we can popularize. For example, you can all share this among all the engineers, this YouTube link. Let every engineer see this talk so that we'll work together. And you raise your hand in WhatsApp or Facebook that you will be willing to work for it. Let us all form a group and work. And we have Telegram group where we can add up to 10,000 people also. If we have 10,000 people, we can achieve anything together. So finally, arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached. So let's not complain about anything. We will work together, we'll arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached. I am ready to work for it, and join, we'll all work together and achieve our goal of seeing engineers in a respected position in the society and seeing engineers doing good for the society. So I'll share, okay, I'm talking so much what I'm doing. I'm heading a company called Shivani Projects and Consultants Private Limited. And my slogan is setting values for excellence. A consultant is expected to deliver excellence, but along with excellence, we give the values. Yeah, Dr. Abdul Kalam is a great man. We should all remember, emulate. Till the last breath, he was doing great things. So these are all the projects. Every year, 94, I started my company, and we have been doing the projects. Each year, I am showing some of the projects for. No, freshers can be trained. Internship is possible. So these are all the projects I have done. Our company has done, and we have this Kirby. We have Satyam Computer since 95, and then Tech Mahindra since 2009. And IT parks we have done, residential projects we have done, this IT park, industrial projects, industries and housing colonies, townships. And so this is the Satyam Information Center and ISB 20 story tower. And we have done industrial building. I shared these examples in my lectures, but today I'm showing you the photographs that we have done and completed, even in interior jobs. We have done this kind of interior jobs and stadium, indoor stadium in my alma mater, JNTU Engineering College. And these are industrial projects and apartments, townships, master plan. This is apartment completed photograph, quality things and infrastructure projects and independent houses, apartments and interiors in the apartments and a school, institutional projects. And this is a township and IT parks and defense projects. This is industrial automobile. And this is the interiors in the industry, master plan of a central business district and all this defense housing, IT park, and Andhra Pradesh interim capital, government complex, secretariat and assembly we have designed, and Bhuvaneshwar, IT park and infrastructure for the defense, and shipyard, Cochin shipyard. We have won the design competition, Tech Mahindra and DigiMap, Marriott accommodation project, and government offices and bank data centers. And this is a IT park in Agartala, Tripura, and housing, affordable housing. Yeah, 25 years for our first project, and housing and malls and multiplexes and infrastructure, flyover and industrial clusters and housing. Now it's going on and campus is also going on this. So we offer architectural services, civil and structural services, MEP, air conditioning, firefighting, project management, quality assurance, quality audits, and value engineering. So these are all the things I have conducted for bringing a manual for telecom towers, because there is no proper code. And in Singapore, I presented a paper on communication towers. And Dubai, we visited Burj Khalifa as a technical team to understand the technology used. And China, we have visited along with the vendor evaluation. And then presented papers in Structural Engineers World Congress in Italy and Korea, spatial structures, and London. During construction, I visited this site, and Seoul Samsung has arranged a visit to their facilities. And Moscow, I presented a keynote lecture on precast, and Singapore SCWC, I presented a paper on future of codes. And this is a man, my God, living God, Bill Baker, I met in 2017 in Bangalore, and that's my happiness, you can see. And also presented a paper in Istanbul in 2019. And I was in US recently for World of Concrete. And Jay Thomas is an expert in retrofitting, actually. And these are all the NATCONs of CREDAI I attend. They are well-organized events in Jakarta, London, Berlin, and Tel Aviv recently. So this is my exposure, and also train engineers, electrical engineers in transmission towers. I have trained about 20 batches in Central Institute of Rural Electrification. And these are all the accolades I received from my clients for different projects. So I had the opportunity to meet many central ministers and chief ministers because I am a civil engineer. So this is about my background a little bit, and thank you all. And I specifically thank KGK Murthy Garu, who is a regular attendee of this, and Mandalika, who was my colleague, is a very senior man, 80 years young only. And Sai Akula every day posting PDF files in the Facebook. Pradeep Dharam creating Telegram group. And Bhaskar, my colleague, who is every day recording this YouTube and posting in YouTube. And my colleagues and associates giving me the data whenever I call at night 10 o'clock for some drawings or some photographs. So there is a lot of background work that happened for the making these presentations. And all the participants, I think I have connected with about 10,000 engineers during these 32 hours lectures, 10,000 across the country. And I thank all of you for encouraging me, and you have given me the energy to work for it. Believe me, I never slept before 12 o'clock these 30 days. But normally I sleep at 9:30. In the lockdown period, I'm sleeping at 12 o'clock because I have to prepare my presentation. Morning, I have to upload PDF. And Facebook, this is really good. And it allowed us to have this live sessions free of cost. And Airtel for very good data connectivity. We have seen, except for two interruptions, it was very good. So, hours of quality time in 32 days. Every day, we had a quality time. Thank you all. And now I'm ready to take any questions. Thank you, sir. I'm also thinking, after seeing the people's requirements and all, I'm thinking that I'll start some online courses designed for specific function, like design engineer, CAD engineer, BIM engineer, construction engineer, scheduling engineer, planning engineer, like that. I will create some courses specifically designed, and not a fresher. No, we take freshers also in our company. Every company will take freshers. Don't think that. But you should have some internship. Lot to help all in this group. Yeah, thank you, Hemant Reddy Garu. On ethical values. This is wonderful experience. Yeah, for me also, it's a great experience. I was really worried. I was sinking into depression before I started this. I thought I must do something. So every day is an inspiration for me. The feedback from all of you. I am learning from you also. Knowledge, we all should learn. Yeah, that's right. I learned a lot of new things during this. I referred codes, I referred internet to give you these presentations apart from my own experience. My past records, I put them in order. Many of the past records. Yes. Yeah, Mohammed Rafi, thank you. So I will create at least 6 to 8 courses and I will announce in the WhatsApp and Telegram groups. And of course, they will not be free things. We will do it on WebEx actually, most probably. And on WebEx, we will train physically by sharing the software and how to do the design, hands-on experience kind of thing. Construction management. Yeah, you can go to NICMAR or NAC also is giving training. NAC is also offering good construction management training. Thank you, Nitin. Problem in India is anybody without any qualification in the field can become a developer. Yeah, that is a problem. Builder's license is there now. RERA is one thing that can regulate. Thank you. Thank you, Mohammed Rafi. When we share, we get more actually. We should empty the water, old water in the tank so that you'll get fresh water. Yeah. Yeah, it will be reasonable charge. It will be reasonable charge. I don't, because I want serious people who want to really learn. I'm seeing in the classes, I'm taking some classes in engineering college online. People come half an hour late for the class. That's very bad actually. Thank you, Vallabha sir. Ganesh, as you shared very grateful knowledge to us, the journey of 31 were very helpful. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. How can I meet you in person? Anytime we can meet, sir. Anytime. Please keep FB. We follow in your leisure time. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We can meet like this, if not. But WebEx is a better platform, or we can use some other meeting platform to meet online also. I'll keep sharing information. Please don't leave the WhatsApp groups. I'll keep sharing some information as we move forward. What would you suggest a young civil engineer who has just passed out and entering this competitive world? Yeah, you have to be a good civil engineer first. Is there any effect on construction industry, private project due to lockdown? Yeah, it will be slowdown will be there, but definitely it will pick up. There will be redesigning of the products, but there will be demand. Helped us to spend time usefully. Yeah. Thank you, Ishan Kamraj. I have many people have volunteered to work with me. I will now form a group. I am from Andhra Pradesh. I am born in East Godavari, place called Rajol, Venkatraman. Can you share all lecture video? Yeah, it is there in YouTube, please. My Pannada Surya Prakash is my name. In my name, channel is there. All the lectures are there. There are 150 videos in my channel. WhatsApp groups. Yeah, it is there. Link is there in the Facebook page. No. FB8 group you can join. Please include SAP 2000 RCDC. Yeah, I have those software. ETAPS online. Yeah, sure. How to become entrepreneur? Yeah, first you should have the knowledge, then you should do good service, then you will become an entrepreneur automatically. Naturally, I mean, you cannot become an entrepreneur by design. You have to be an entrepreneur in your nature. Actually, you should have that killing urge to do something on your own. I'll meet you and learn. Yeah, welcome, Ishak. Some new things. Yeah, yeah, you are welcome. Narendra Madhav, you can join Telegram group. If you please go to our page timeline and you will see all the things. Thank you, Pradeep. STAT Pro, ETAB, in fact, both have different advantages. You have to use depending on the type of structure, which software. But first think of doing it manually, any design. Don't think of the software. You should design on your own and then use the software to confirm your design values are correct like that. FDI to India, that is right, Manikanta. I am also expecting use FDI post this lockdown period, post COVID actually. Yeah. We should meet every month. That's right. Great journey. Thank you. You please share the codes available. It's available online now. Codes are available online. Yeah. Great. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, casting software, I'll do it. Autocast. Valuable time and sharing bundles of experience. Yeah. For freshers like me, your lectures are giving good. Yeah, please, I request all the freshers to prepare a report for these 12 lectures. 20 lectures I have got today, I will be sending the certificate for those who has given the reports. 27 reports I got. So I'll issue 27 certificates and 5 are with distinction. And they'll get a prize money also. Those 5 who have prepared very good reports, I'm very happy with them and we'll share that. Yeah, thank you, Jagdish Keshwani. So, I'll call it a day, and apart from this lecture, we met in Jain. Yeah, that's right, 2017. That's right, Muhammad Ishaq, you remember very well. Yeah, thank you, Amol. Bye bye, sir. KGK Garu, namaste. We'll meet again and I'll talk to you after this. India will face huge labor issue after lockdown. No, not necessarily. Thank you, Subramaniam. I hope it is helpful to all of us and let us utilize what we have got. And I'm going to start working from day after tomorrow in my office. Thank you. Bye. See you.